2 months ago, I released a video of me installing Windows 11 on a Ryzen 5 1600. What happened after I installed the operating system? Was it worth it? Did anything break? Spoiler, yes it did. And most importantly, how does it perform? Hey guys, Wano here, and in this video, we will be going through the journey since I installed Windows 11 on my Ryzen 5 1600 PC and if you should do it. But before we get into all of that, remember to subscribe to the channel and click that like button since it will really make my day. Alright, so let's start at the beginning. You all know I installed Windows 11 on my main PC because I was curious as to how well it would perform and I just loved the idea of how it looked and the promises that Microsoft made. I did this and to my surprise, everything went pretty smoothly. I had the occasional taskbar glitch, but that was to be expected of a new operating system. If all went well, I could probably end this video just right now and say I installed the operating system and you should also do it, right? Yeah, in a perfect world maybe, but there always has to go something wrong. The system crashed. After about 3 weeks of having Windows 11 as my main and only operating system, something weird happened. I was playing some CSGO with some friends when all of a sudden my computer froze. I could still hear my friends and talk to them, but that was about it. So naturally, I restarted my PC, only to find that it won't boot. It hung on the boot screen and I knew something was wrong. I diagnosed my PC from every angle that you can think of. I even took off my side panels in fear that something was short-circuiting in my PC. In the end though, it was my SSD. Something happened and my whole SSD crashed. It wasn't even at a point where I could get a new operating system because every single time the SSD was in my PC, it just couldn't boot. Was it Windows 11 that broke my SSD? I have no idea. Luckily, I could use a temporary hard drive to set up Windows 10, but I did lose a lot of work, so please remember to set up some kind of cloud storage for your important stuff. So after that, I just ignored Windows 11 in fear that I would break my PC if I installed it again. And that is why I never made the benchmarks video after that, but alas, this is not where our story ends. I was working one day with Windows 10 still on my PC when I saw a notification at the bottom of my screen. Windows 11 upgrade is ready and it's free. I found nothing on the subject, so I just decided to go for it again. I downloaded Windows 11 and it has been more than a month of every single day use. My Windows 11 still works fine. How does it perform, you ask? Well, I have done some benchmarks on games that I usually play. I included CSGO, Valorant, GTA 5 and The Witcher 3. According to what I remember from Windows 10, there is no noticeable difference between the performance of the two operating systems. I recorded some footage, so you should be able to judge for yourself. While watching the benchmarks, please remember to like the video as it helps boost the video in the YouTube algorithm. So as you can see, I got decent frames in all of the games that I played, and in some of them, like CSGO, I lost some FPS due to the recording software. So there you have it, this has been the journey so far. I would recommend switching to Windows 11 only if you like the UI or the features. Apart from that, there's not too much of a difference in performance. Thank you for watching the video, and if you enjoyed it, please remember to smash that like button and subscribe if this is the type of content that you want to see. With that being said, I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.